Hi guys, today we'll be doing a test video on the tracking to see if we can use a Hubsan Zino Mini Pro to track my left side Inspire 1, Dji Inspire 1 as it flies up in the air. So I suppose this might be big enough to track, so we'll check it out later on. And on my right side I have the DJI Mini, which is used to do the filming on the activities of these two drones doing their own thing. So without further ado, let me start up the motors for the DJI Mini, and then we'll bring it up to its location. Okay, so after DJI Mini is up, I'm flying up the Hubsan Zino Mini. Do notice actually it's very difficult to line it up together because all these drones are very small up in the air. Okay, now the Hubsan Mini is up, so I'll bring up the DJI Inspire. And prior to this, I've already done one test, flew up all these three drones, and I just noticed that Hubsan did not update the application for iOS, so I have to bring all this drone down. I do not know what happened to Hubsan. They forgo the iOS update, but they only do it for the Android. Okay, so as the Inspire 1 enter the video feed, now I'm gonna move my hands to the remote for my Hubsan Zino. I'll select following mode. I'll do active track. I have to draw a square on this, and immediately it appears to track. Okay, so it tracks, so I have to move my hand to the remote for my Inspire. Try to move a bit. Okay, it doesn't track. I think probably it's like too small, too far away. Let me try that again. It says what, target was lost, currently searching. So it search again. Once it's found, it says go. So I think the circle that I drew is too small. So next time, well, if you are doing any of this tracking shot, make sure the subject is a little bigger or you're closer to your subject. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna move closer, move my Zino Mini closer to the Inspire. Okay. Here I'm at least a bit closer, so you need like at least a 5 to 15 meter away. Okay, make sure you check your surrounding. Following mode, I'm using active track. Okay, do notice the feed is a bit blurry. I think it's because this is in photo mode, so once I select to video mode, it is much better. So as we continue tracking, I'm also trying to take a video to change to video mode, but it is not possible. So it is only after you stop the tracking, then you can switch it to the video mode. So it's advisable next time when if you want to do a tracking with a video, you have to start the recording first, then you select the tracking function. Okay, so let's try again. Now we are try to draw a bigger box. Okay, go. Okay, alright. Maybe I flew too fast. So when you are doing the tracking, please give it some time for your drone to react to your movements. So I hope you get a glimpse on how this active track works. Maybe later on I'll try it on my RC car to see how well it tracks, because definitely this terrain might not be the best for tracking because of maybe the drone is white in color and also the terrain is quite of a similar color. So I'll bring the drone back. And maybe this is a failed mission because I could not track it 100%. This gave me like 70% tracking. I hope you enjoy this small experiment. as I bring back the drone. If you dislike this video, please give it a like, and maybe you'll not try to attempt this kind of tracking because it clearly it doesn't work. And if you have any question or if you have any comments, leave it down in the comment section, and I'll see you in the next one with another type of tracking. So thank you very much. I'll see you again. Bye bye.